What's your name?
Darcy. Oh.
Darcy, where are you from?
I'm from Canada.
Are you living in the UK or are you?
I'm not. No, I came here just for this. So.
How old are you, Darcy?
I'm 26.
And what got you into the act that you're doing today?
When I was a kid, actually, I had hopes and dreams of becoming a doctor, but my parents insisted that I become a magician. So here I am.
Darcy, I think you're the best magician I've ever seen on this show. Absolutely no idea how you did that. It's frustrating me quite a lot now, thinking about it. But it was fantastic.
Darcy, Darcy, Darcy. That was absolutely fantastic, and it helps that you look fantastic as well. It does!
The most important thing about magic is making us believe the impossible is possible. And you just did that.
Wow, thank you.
Yeah, agree.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
Simon?
You are, without question, the best magician we've ever had on the show. Here's what I've got to ask you, Darcy, because I do love animals. I mean, are those birds okay?
Of course, yeah.
Okay, well, I've got to say, Darcy, you weren't corny. It was very difficult what you did. And I think that we've uncovered a star with you. I really do.
Well, we are going to have to take a vote now. David.
Darcy, I'm going to say yes.
Amanda? Oh, absolutely without question, yes.
Yes from me. That's...
Dream Team Mel B, baby, it's time to roll. Let me tell you this. If you want to be great in this world, it's very simple. Surround yourself with great, great people. So, I'm trying to be like all four of you. I guess if we're going to do a trick, if I'm trying to be like you, I thought, well, clearly we'll start with some wine glasses, apparently. So there we go. I also have a deck of cards. And these cards right here are in what's called new deck order, which means the cards are in order. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take the ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 of spades. And I'm just gonna take them and set them in the wine glass right in front of you, Simon. I'm now gonna take the ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And I'm gonna walk these on down to Howie. Here you go, Howie. Take those cards, just shuffle them.
Shuffle?
Give them a quick mix. Take half those.
Okay.
And hand them to Heidi. Yeah. Now, both of you, just kind of mix up the few cards you got. You can put some on the bottom, some on the top, some in the middle. Perfect. Howie, hand them on down to Heidi.
All of them?
Yeah. Okay. And if you want, you can give them a quick shuffle, or just pass them on down to Mel B. Here we go. All right, shuffle them up, do what you got to do. Look, I used to want to steal greatness from everybody around me so that I can get accolades and awards, hit milestones in my career. But what I realize is I'm a dad now. Now I'm trying to surround myself with greatness so that I can take it home and share it with my little girl. Be the dad I never had, be the best dad I can possibly be. So, Mel B, take those cards and hand them to Simon.
Thanks.
Simon, you're the last one. You're gonna take a few, put it on the bottom, cut them, shuffle them, do nothing. This is up to you. You feel good? I'll take them. You happy? You good? Here are the diamonds that you all mixed up. And you know what? I'm gonna put these right here. Yeah. Simon, I'm gonna take these and I'm actually gonna spread them out so you can see the order that you shuffled them in. I'm gonna take my finger and just run it across the deck. Simon, just yell out the word stop.
Stop.
I'm gonna go straight down.
Yeah.
Right here. We got a four of diamonds and I'm gonna reverse it. Stick it in the deck just like that. Square it up. And these cards are gonna go right here in this wine glass just like that. If I'm trying to be just like you, if you shuffle the six, I guess all I gotta do is find myself a six. But you all shuffled these cards. When I walked out here, I said, I'm trying to be like every one of you. So if you all shuffle the three, I guess I'm gonna find my three. You want an eight? There's my eight. You want a five? There's my five.
Crazy.
You want a seven? There's the seven. Man, surround yourself with greatness. Give the world everything you got. Simon, you picked one card and one card only. You could have said stop anywhere. You wanted a four of diamonds. Right in front of you, I thought, what the heck? Simon, there's my four. There's the tens. There's the aces. There's the nines. Man, it's a great day to decide to be happy, baby. My name's John Dornbos. Peace out. I love you, man. I love you.
Mel B chose wisely.
Thank you.
I tell you what, John, what you reminded me of is it's not just enough to have talent. You've got to have personality.
Yes.
You've always been an amazing performer. Compared to when I first saw your audition to now, this was you at your very best.
Love you.
Who you really are and the hurdles that you have gone through in life and what you have created for yourself and your family and that little girl out there, you are truly a champion.
Thank you.
I love you too, and I'm also very, very mad that you're not on my team. And usually Simon hates card tricks, and not tonight, it seems
not
like.
Tonight.
No, not tonight.
I now love it again.
What can I say? You're just incredible. Thank you for being part of my dream team. Yes!
Rock on, thanks for having me. I love you guys. Thank you.
Thank you, John. He's such a great guy.
Why did you not push the golden buzzer?
Because I think it's too early in the night, and I believe that he's so likable that they're gonna vote for him anyway.
So do I.
Okay, so like most teenagers, I am permanently attached to my phone. Unfortunately, I'm currently banned off all technology at the moment. You don't need to know why. But it basically means I need to borrow a phone from one of the judges for my act today. So, Who's gonna trust a 15-year-old with their phone? Alicia, thank you so much.
Don't, whatever you do, go through the search history.
Okay, so what if I could unlock your phone without you telling me the password?
Well, that would be genius.
Okay, now look into my eyes. I'm gonna try and reach into your mind and find it. You're trying so hard not to picture your password. Okay, I got it.
Oh, right.
What?
Okay.
Okay, so now for everyone's favorite thing, audience participation.
Yeah. She was like a nervous wreck just before.
Okay, so if you had a birthday last year, please stand up. If you were born on an even day of the month, can you hold your hands out like this as if you're holding your birthday present? And if you were born on an odd day of the month, hold your hands together as if you're making a birthday wish. Okay, now everyone just hold that pose. I'm gonna take a photo and tell my mum I got a standing ovation. Okay, you can all sit down now if you like. So now Shane, I have yellow and red coloured silks. Can you please name one for me?
Yellow.
Yellow? Okay. So then you can have the yellow one. You can get out your phone and try and copy what I do. So that leaves me with the red one.
Not now, sweetheart. Really busy. Got to call you back.
Bye. Can everyone watch this?
Oh.
You can have your phone back now.
Thank you so much.
Oh, so good. Okay, and now, David, we don't want to leave you out. So as you can see, I have 8 balloons here. Can you please name one balloon, like name a number from 1 to 8 for me?
7.
7?
Yep.
Okay, so now most people, they go with something easier, like 3.
7.
Okay, so you didn't pick 1. You didn't pick 2. You sure you don't want to pick 3?
I'm sure.
You didn't pick 4? Or 5? Or 6? Pick 7?
Yes.
Okay. All right, now everyone, don't blink.
Judges, join me on stage.
Oh, no.
People remember me getting a golden buzzer from Neil Patrick Harris. So to thank him, I gave him a bite of my sandwich. Tonight I'm here to tell you, we're gonna make the greatest sandwich ever. Who's with me? We're starting with you, Harry.
Okay.
12 toasters fully loaded, son. You're gonna pick up those dice. You can use 1 or 2. Which one do you want?
I'll do 1.
Do 1?
All right.
Roll those dice to choose a slice. Off you go. That's it. Where is it gonna land on? Dun, 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 dun. Number 1. Oh, bang, number 1. Harry, back to your seat. We've got white bread to start off with. Now we need a meat to go with the white bread, please. Simon, you're going to spin this wheel of meat. I hope you're not a vegan. This is quite heavy. Off you go. There you go, Simon. Come on. No, oh, look, you've broken it.
Oh my gosh, literally
broke it. I'll just be the little flappy thing. Okay, Simon, are you happy with tuna or do you want bacon?
Tuna.
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 I'll do bacon.
Give it up for Simon. Simon's back to his seat. Heidi.
Yes.
Do you have a pen?
No.
You're going to take the pen, please, Heidi.
Yes.
You're going to write your name, Heidi, on the little stickers that say Heidi.
Got it.
Okay, that's yes. it. Heidi, please. Now, Heidi,
yes.
I'm also going to need a hair. The longest hair you can find, yeah?
Just yeah.
Pull it out, please, Heidi. Yeah. Pull it out. Let's have a look at it.
Oh! What?
Yeah.
Does that work?
Oh, you got a clump of them. That, yeah, that's...
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Is that okay?
This is gross. You got a few little straggly ones there, didn't you? Now, let's get back to the sandwich and this cheese board. All right, pick up the darts. Give me your best shot, Heidi. Okay, I hear something. Colby, Jack, give it up for Heidi. Back to your seat, Heidi. Pick up those rings, Melby. Face those vegetables. All right, if you like one, put a ring on it. Oh, we're good. No, it's not going to bounce on the end.
Chili.
A chili. Give it up for Mel B as Mel B returns to her seat. And to choose our final topping, please welcome little Mr. Pivots. Oh. Look at him. He's still going. Jay, spin that turntable of toppings. Off you go. Mr. Pivots, stop one with the power of your mind. Anyone you want. Anyone you want, buddy, with the power of your mind. It looks like ketchup. We're going ketchup. That's it. Perfect. Oh, lovely. We've got the tomato ketchup. We've got the chili. We've got the Colby Jack. We've got the white bread. And, of course, we have the tuna, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is it just me? Or is there something missing?
Hi, Piff. It's me. Inside the safe is my gift to you. The greatest sandwich of all time. I hope you enjoy it, Piff. You've earned it. With much admiration, Neil, the Sandwich King, Patrick Harris.
Neil Patrick Harris put a sandwich in that safe. Terry?
Yes, sir.
Get out here. Give it up for Terry. Terry, we're going to lower that safe down. Jonas, do not take your eyes off of that safe.
We're not taking Terry, it off.
Now, you notice it's locked with a combination lock.
Okay.
I believe the first number to be zero.
All right.
Try a second zero. Third zero. Hang on, zero, zero, zero. Zero. Oh! Bang!
Yes.
Got it first time.
Yes.
Terry, open up the safe. Is there a sandwich bag for me?
Yes.
You're going to reach into the bag. You're going to remove the sandwich that I'm praying is there.
Okay. There it is. Oh, wow.
Place this over here on my head.
Oh, there it is.
All right. Give it up for Terry. I'm going to open up the sandwich. Is it me, Heidi? Is that white bread like how we chose?
Yes.
It is?
It is.
Okay. Simon, do you remember what you chose to meat?
Tuna.
Tuna. Is that tuna there,
yeah.
Heidi?
Yeah.
What kind of cheese is that?
The cheese that I picked.
Colby Jack?
Yes.
Mel B, look, what's that? What's that just there?
Chilies.
Chilies?
Yeah. Chilies.
What?
Heidi, are you going to stick a finger in that?
I don't know about that.
Come on, Heidi. Just stick a finger in
okay,
there.
Okay, it's all for you.
Yeah, sit, lick it. Lick it. That's it, perfect. Perfect. Lick it.
No.
Is that ketchup?
It is ketchup.
Yeah. But wait. I've got to test the sandwich.
No.
Yes. Yes.
Hello.
What is it? What is it?
I think there's a missing ingredient.
What?
With the hair.
My name's Piff the Mighty Dragon. Good night.
Yes.
Standing ovation.
That's amazing.
How did they do that?
No idea.
Honestly, I have never seen Simon Cowell this gobsmacked. You're gobsmacked, yes or yes?
Seriously, yes. You delivered, I think, the best overall performance I've seen from you.
Yeah!
And you know what? Maybe this is the year you are going to win.
Possible.
You didn't
just say you want to win. You came with a winning performance. You really did.
I believe in magic, so I'm trying to... I don't even want to know how you did it, because it's magic.
Yeah, I'm not going to tell you, Mel.
I wish you good luck. I hope you will win it this time.
We're going to win it, Heidi.
You're going to win it.
Simon, that was the best performance he's ever done.
I totally agree.
You should have used your buzzer.
It's a strategy. I know
it's
what I'm doing.
It's a bad strategy, Howie. It's like
magic. Hello.
Hello.
Wow. Not often do people show up ready to celebrate.
I just graduated university. Oh, celebrate with some beer.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you. What was your major?
I majored in computer science.
I hear that computers are going to really take off shortly.
Probably.
I hear. What is your name?
Savio. I'm Savio Joseph.
But if you just graduated in computer science, what are you doing here?
My love and passion ever since I was a kid is actually doing magic. If I can prove myself here on this stage, I know it would change my life forever.
So you're going to base the rest of your life on what happens here tonight?
Yes.
Wow.
No pressure.
How are your parents with this?
My parents are actually here tonight, somewhere in the audience, and they're so supportive.
I wish you nothing but the best.
Thank you, Howie. That means the world.
Go for it, buddy.
All right, I'm going to join you up on stage, if that's okay. I'm going to bring this over here. Let's do this. Howie, I want you to just please watch the beer. Please don't drink it all, because we're going to get back to this.
Okay.
I need to borrow a $100 bill, or any bill, actually, if anyone's got a bill on them.
I have no money.
My wife always gives me, like, $100 just in case I get lost.
Okay, yeah.
Just one.
Can you do me a favor? Can you actually autograph the bill nice and big? Boom, there you go. This bill now represents something really special. This bill is now going to represent a possibility of a future. I also brought some other envelopes here with me as well. And these contain other possible career choices I can take instead of doing magic. Cardinal, I want you to start this off. I want you to use your intuition to try to find the outcome where I follow my dreams.
I'm gonna go with number one.
Number one, this one right here. Take a look. I want you to rip the top open and open it up inside. What did you get? What is the outcome you got?
Game designer.
Game designer, okay.
Oh.
I told you this was really a choice that I need to make. Four buzzes, and I'm really gonna hang this up.
Pressure's on.
I don't like this.
Trish, you're only playing with my future, so please choose wisely.
Okay, no pressure, right?
No pressure, yes.
Okay, number two.
Here you go, rip it open, take a look inside. I don't even wanna look. What did you get?
Engineer.
Oh. Oh, buddy, yourself.
Lily. Whichever one you don't choose, I'm gonna set on fire. Lily, look, you're brown, I'm brown, we got that brown connection. Please don't fail me here, okay? I'm really banking on you.
All the pressure
here.
Under my... And your parents are like, yes, engineer, yes, do that one.
Lily, which one do you want?
I'm gonna go with number one.
Okay, hold on to this. Don't open it just yet.
Okay.
I'm gonna leave this here. I'm gonna grab a can just so I can do this safely.
What if it's your $100
bill? What if it's my 100?
Then I'm sorry, Howie. Okay. Lily, for the moment of truth, please open it up. And if all went well, this will be the signed $100 bill and the crowd
please
will go
nuts.
Please
be the 100, the 100, the 100,
the 100!
The crowd
is gonna go nuts.
Oh.
No!
No. Web developer.
Oh, shh. Oh, that's,
No! Three buzzers.
Howie, you didn't get to make a choice.
What are you doing? What are you gonna do?
Name a number between 1 and 6, and Howie, please choose wisely.
4.
1, 2, 3, 4. If you take a look inside here, actually. Judges, can you actually take a stand and move to the right? I don't want any of you getting hurt in this process.
This is intense right now.
Okay. Howie, can you actually come here? Can you do me a favor?
Okay.
We'll do, okay. How about this? I go like this, and you hold this end over here. Like that? Yes.
Like perfect. This?
Yes.
Unscroll it?
Yes, unscroll it slowly, slowly. You know what's crazy? It actually says on here, Cardinal was gonna pick game designer. Is that the one you selected? Okay, let's keep going. And if you actually take a look over here, it says Trish is gonna pick engineer. If you actually keep going, let's keep going. It actually says over here, Lily, you're gonna get web developer. Hold on.
That's amazing.
Howie, wait, hold on. That says at Savio Joseph TV. Shameless self-plug.
I respect that.
Keep going.
Howie, but here's the thing. We didn't just burn your bill. We sent your bill back in time, back when I was thinking what I was gonna do on this stage to hopefully impress you guys. Really slowly unravel the ending portion of this so you can all see this. Is that your signature? It's like magic.
Oh my goodness.
Oh.
Oh my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Savio Joseph. Thank you so, so much.
My magical sidekick since I was 7. We're best friends. Say hi to everyone. I guess he's a little shy. May I join with you?
Yes.
Howie?
Yes.
Do you believe that my friend can tell you his name?
Yes.
Okay, now close your eyes.
Okay.
Try to focus and connect with my friend. My friend will tell you his name. You got a name?
I did.
Okay, now open your eyes, write the name, and then turn the pad over.
Okay.
Don't show it to anyone.
And what?
Show it to everyone and turn it back over.
Show it to everyone?
You're the mentor.
No, don't show it to anyone.
Oh, don't show it to anyone.
Yes.
Did you mentor this act or not?
It's over. It's turned over.
Thanks, Howie. Everyone, let's give Howie a hand. Heidi?
Yes?
Do you believe that my friend can read your mind?
Maybe, yeah.
Okay, let's try then.
Okay.
Can you think one color?
Mm-hmm.
Are you done?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's say it together in a count of three.
Okay.
One, two, three.
Red!
Red? You choose red?
Yes.
Oh dear, my friend is a bit jet-lagged. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Now, Melby, can you please check my blindfold? Make sure it's legit.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And Simon, can you hold onto this doll?
Yes.
Thanks. Okay, Simon, in a second, you will throw the doll into the audience.
Anywhere?
I'm covering my eyes to connect with my friend. Simon, please throw it.
Yeah, they have it.
Hello.
Hi.
What was that? Okay. Are you wearing a navy t-shirt?
Yeah.
Are you wearing glasses?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Wow, that's wild.
Thank you. Oh, Howie, you wrote down my friend's name earlier.
Yes, I did.
Now, for the first time, can you show us the name you wrote down?
Yes. I wrote down my name backwards.
So...
Iwa.
Iwa?
Iwa.
Iwa?
Okay, Iwa. I just got my friend a name necklace yesterday.
Yes.
So, the name is... Iwa!
That says Iwa.
Thank you very much.
Is that it?
Yes. Yes!
You can check it.
Wow, look, it's red and it says Iwa.
Show me.
It's
Why did
red.
You have to pick such a complicated name?
That was fantastic. You're only 15
Thank
years
you.
Old. It's your first time in America. That was magical. What did you think, Heidi?
I liked it. I mean, I was confused at times, but we got there.
I mean, you as a person, you're so adorable and you're so cute, but I think this act was a little bit small for this stage. And I think what you can take from that is think even bigger and better.
That's good. All That's right. good advice.
Simon?
I think because we've seen so much amazing magic over the years, this didn't have that wow moment.
What?
I think you got the wrong mentor, if I'm being honest with you, Pritzi. I think, look,
what?
This is,
harsh
I get
words,
it, you're 15.
Simon, harsh words.
It still works.
It did.
Yeah.
But there's only five acts that are going to go through to the next round, so good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank
wrong
you.
Mentor? Wrong mentor?
Yeah.
Wrong mentor?
Terrible mentor. You, as the mentor, shouldn't have been the person, because it looked like you rigged it.
Set up, yeah.
I didn't rig it.
It felt like a set up.
I would agree. And she's only 15. You're how old, Howie?
Stop.
So this is your dream, yeah?
It is.
All right, well, good luck.
Thank you very much.
So far, so good.
Going.
Well done so far.
Good luck.
I put a spell on you.
Hi.
Hello.
Do you want to tell us who you are, please?
Mandy Mewden.
And where are you from?
London.
All right. Mandy, how old are you?
Let's just say I've seen a few summers and leave it there, Simon.
That's a good answer. We've all seen a few summers, Mandy. Is this what you do full time?
Yeah, I'm a bit of a performer.
Have you nearly had that opportunity where you had that break?
To be quite honest, not really, because my family don't even really know who I am, so no, no.
They don't know who you are?
No, they're always confused when I come home, but, you know. I keep trying, you never know.
All right, well, look, good luck.
Thank you very much.
This is right up my street.
It's fun.
OK, now, I'm going to show you something that is a little bit extraordinary, OK? Whatever I write or draw on this pad becomes a reality.
What?
I was hoping I'd be a bit older when the melons dropped. Now, I'm completely psychiatric, psychotic, and some people do actually call me a witch. And David, I'm being very drawn to you. Can you feel me stroking your aura? You will in a minute. Now, David, I'm going to try and read your mind. I want you to think of somebody, David, that you're very, very attracted to. Who is it, David, that you're very, very attracted to?
Simon!
That's interesting. Now, Alicia, I'm being drawn to you, and I want you to think of something you like to do most days. All right, here we go. All right, what are you thinking of?
Food.
She's gone.
She's brilliant, this girl.
I love her.
Right, Simon, because it's you, dear, I want you to think of a number between 1 and 5,000. Make it really hard for me, all right? Here we go, Simon. Are you thinking? OK, this'll be it. What number were you thinking of?
777.
That is uncanny. Amanda.
Yeah?
Would you be so kind as to join me on stage?
Amanda,
Amanda, doesn't she look gorgeous? Would you mind to sit on that stool? Now, Amanda, just touch any card
touch
any card. Take it out. Look at it. OK, I'm going to make a prediction of what it is. Show everybody and remember it. OK. Just to say, David, you're very attracted to Simon, and I don't blame you with that lovely jawline. Alicia, you like food?
What?
And your number was 777. Was that right, Simon?
Yes.
But that says 770.
Oh, maybe I got that one wrong, but let's move on. Okay. Sometimes witches can't be perfect. Now, Amanda,
yes.
What was the card?
It was the Four of Spades.
The Four of... Was it?
Yes.
Not the three?
No, it was a four.
So we're a spade missing then, everybody. OK, well, look, here it is.
I think she was really good.
Hello! What's your name, my friend?
My name is Ben, Magic Ben.
And where are you from?
Kangutsu York. K-A-N-G-I-Q-S-U-J-U-A-Q. A little complicated. Very, very small town, about 800 people, only flying in and out in northern Quebec. And when there's a blizzard, well, you're stuck there.
What's it like wanting to get into magic when you're in a small community?
I'll be honest, I wasn't fitting in really. And magic was what kept my focus. And when school was done, I would go back to my room, practice in front of the mirror. And it would make me forget about whatever had happened that day.
Wow, I love that. Well, listen, we cannot wait
to see what you have in store for us. Good luck.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Hello, sir.
I think you may want to start this with Trish. I'm just...
Are you sure?
He gets a little freaked out with magic.
We're going to do very simple card tricks. Please, okay. Any card you want.
Any card?
Any card. Okay, perfect. Take a look at it. Show everybody. Just hold it out.
Okay.
Perfect. Good. And let's lose it somewhere in the middle. So tell me when to stop.
Stop.
Perfect. Put it back right there. Now remember what I said. I didn't fit in. And no matter how low I got, I always came back on top. Watch. Take your right pointer finger and touch the back of the deck for me. Take a look. Show everybody.
See, so what happens is, when he gets freaked out, it's a good thing.
Thank you.
It's a good thing.
Should we try it with you?
Yes.
I'm going to slide it in the middle. Now, where's the 10 of clubs?
Just right there.
Are you sure? I'll show it to you. This one here?
Yeah, that one there.
Okay, give it a push for me. Just a push. Put your finger on top. Like I said, didn't matter how low I got, I always came back to the top. Take a look. And jumps back on top.
What?
Thank you.
Oh my goodness.
Now, Lily, it's your turn.
Yes, Harry Potter.
Here's what I want you to do. I want you to sign across that card one big nice signature, okay? Actually, you know what? Write something mean on there.
One word, is that okay?
One word, any word. Go ahead.
What did you write?
I wrote jerk.
Jerk.
That's mean.
I
Why
know.
Would you be so mean?
He made Cardinal run away.
Sorry, Cardinal. It's okay. Just watch over here. Watch. You want to give me your hand? Watch. The 10 of clubs, jerk. I put it in the middle of the deck. Snap my fingers. Oh, that's a joker. Weird. Give me your hand like this. Mm-hmm. Just flat out. Put the cards here. Put your hand on top. And look at me. Now it's very important that you focus right here. Watch. Is this your card?
No.
That's a joker?
Yeah.
Howie, what'd you do? Give me a second chance.
Yeah,
give me a second chance.
Okay, go for it.
What about this one here?
What? Yeah, that's it?
It is? But you know what, audience? That's not a really good trick. You know what we'll do? We'll do something crazier instead, because when I was 9 years old, I had the dream to come here on Canada's Got Talent. I was very young. I was practicing my magic in the mirror, tundra everywhere, but what I always knew was that I was gonna be here. I was gonna be here one day, and I was gonna do this specific piece of magic. Watch. Everybody, audience, on a count of three, I want everybody in the audience to yell out the words magic. One, two, three.
Magic!
Oh, you guys are wonderful. Are you guys ready? On a count of three, we're gonna make the cards that you're holding disappear. Audience, one, two, three.
Magic!
Can you feel them?
I do.
That would have been a really good trick, right, Howie?
Would have been great.
But my dream was clear as ice. Take a look.
What the hell? It's a picture of me.
Making paper airplanes reminds me of fond memories. Well, as we grow older, our memories fade with time.
It's gone.
Memories are invisible. What are the most precious things in my life? Stacked against us both.
I will always.
stacked against us both.
Over there on the other end.
I was excited.
Say it.
Obviously, being his mentor, it's special.
You're not his mentor. You're not.
We have a connection. You've developed this very cool, laid-back Vegas-style persona, world class.
I agree. Now,
you're not just cool, you're kind of very slick and very confident. I love how you are with it all. It's like, yeah, I can do this, yeah, I can do that. Good.
Thank you so much.
Howie!
That was the best magic act I have seen in the last 5 years.
I'm saying a lot.
And the ability to rise to that level working not even with your mentor of choice.
I know.
Good point.
Listen, I see the Heidi in there. I've said this a couple times tonight, only 5 acts can go through. I promise you, you are going to be one of the 5.
Good luck to you!
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Here he is.
Hello.
What is that? He's coming toward us with it.
Coming right to me, to the golden...
It's an apple with razor blades.
Oh. That's sharp. That's sharp. Sharp indeed.
No.
No, no, no,
no. No, no, no. No, no, no. No, 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 no.
Don't try this, kids.
What are you doing to your esophagus? Oh. But he chewed the mint, right?
There's no way.
Yeah, he chewed the mint.
Oh.
No.
Huh?
That's not how you use it.
No, it's not gonna be there.
What,
what's your name?
My name is Aidan McCann.
How old are you, Aidan?
I'm 9.
Oh my God, that's so old. Aidan, what would it mean to you to get through today?
A lot.
Really?
I've been worrying the last few days.
Why?
I was hoping.
Why were you worrying?
I don't know. It's what kids do.
It's what kids do.
Did you watch the great Padini just a minute ago?
Yeah.
What'd you think of him?
He was great.
Yeah. Well, Aidan, do you want to start?
Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so for this trick, I'll need an assistant, a sidekick. So,
who do you want?
Jason. Now, I'm not going to say it's not my fault I bought a small chair. I done it on purpose, okay? So you can just sit down.
He's like a mini version of me.
This deck is yours, and this is a red deck, yeah?
Yeah.
All the cards are different, yeah?
Uh-huh.
You can make sure they're all normal, different.
Yeah.
You happy?
Yeah.
Okay, switch decks.
Ooh.
Find any card, look at it, don't show anybody it, not even the audience, only keep it to yourself.
Yeah.
And place it on top. Okay.
Okay. Oh, God, hang on. I can't do it as slick as you.
Okay, now we're just going to cut the deck again so it's all different. Switch decks again. And now we're going to find our card and place it face down, okay?
Okay, I got it. Do I win?
No.
Oh.
So, well, I didn't know you were playing a game. You should have told me I like games. Okay, so pick up your card and show everybody it.
Okay. Here we go.
Hold it up so everybody can still see us.
Okay.
So now, what are the chances that we pick the same card?
Like none. Like no way. Oh my God! Well done, man. That's really good.
So, once again, all the cards are different, yeah? You can just give them a quick shuffle.
Okay, no problem. You're so confident. When I was your age, whenever he spoke to me, I just puked.
Whenever you're ready, you can place them down again.
I've never met a child older than me in his head.
Great shuffling.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, I'm just going to get you to tell me when to stop wherever you want.
Stop.
Here?
Mm-hmm.
You sure?
I don't know.
So, this card right here is going to be your card, okay? I'm going to show everybody and you, but I'm not going to look.
Okay.
Does everybody know it? Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, you guys need to remember it because I don't think Jason can.
Oh!
Okay, you can give the deck another shuffle.
I'm getting so burnt up here.
Whenever you're ready, you can place it down again.
Oh, do I need a shuffle?
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to go over to you over here. And I just want you to face me.
My knees are bigger than you.
Put out your right hand and make it a fist.
Okay.
Perfect. We're just going to put it up and place the deck right there, okay?
You're so cool.
Okay. Why don't you look at that card and show everybody that card.
Okay. Oh my God. Amazing.
The guy is a genius.
Thank you.
hand up. Come on.
Well, yes. I mean, it's just so subtle and so perfect. You are exceptional.
Thank you.
You are a monster in the magic world, in a good way.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Lisa.
Well, I enjoyed watching Penn during that act as much as I enjoyed watching you. He's so excited, and I can see why. We have the acts come out with the big production, and everything about your act was very subtle. It was fabulous. Well done.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
David.
Well, it was an absolutely brilliant idea. Perfectly executed. It was like a work of art. And we were missing some of the tricks because it was like, oh my God, his waistcoat's changed colour. We hadn't even realised that because we were looking at the cards. Yeah. So simple and yet so complex. Do you get stuff like this at Butlin, Stephen?
Hey, technically, this is like a masterclass, isn't it?
Have you got the rest of the show for me to talk about, Eric? There's something to be said in magic for the big effects. But there's really, when it comes right down to it, no jive, just raw, brutal, unbelievable skill. Those hands, they are the best I've seen.
Yeah. Wow.
With words, we can paint the world with kindness and create magic in everyday moments. Simon, the last time we met, I asked you to think of a magic word which you wrote down on this hanky. Your magic word, dog. I'll leave it here. Now, I know you hate card tricks, but don't worry. It's not one of those. I've written some random words on the back of these cards. Take this half and mix them up whilst I mix these. Howie, please, say stop whenever you want.
Stop.
Read whatever is written on the back, but don't let me see.
Okay.
Simon, in a world that's often upside down, there's a chance for fun and happy moments to pop up when we least expect them. Let's bring our two halves together as one so we can find joy in this chaos. What if we could create a special moment of magic by making these mixed up words rearrange themselves to tell my story? Impossible, right? It's done. Forget what we're told. Simon, I'm here because of you.
Oh.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Howie, I asked you to choose a card which was the
Nine of Spades.
The Nine of Spades. Let's try this. You know, Howie, only those who believe in magic can truly find it. Watch very, very, very closely. What was the word written on the back of the card that you chose?
Believe.
Now, Simon, show everyone what's written on the hanky.
Believe.
James.
My teacher, Mrs. Kirwan, always says If you truly believe, then anything is possible. I used to be on the outside looking in, but now I'm on the inside looking out.
Standing.
Thank you.
Thank you. My gosh.
Howie. You know, this show, AGT and all the GTs around the world, are all about diversity. Anybody from any walk of life should be able to compete and have their dreams come true, including neurodiversity. And yeah. You are truly amazing, not only as a magician, but as a human being.
Thank you very much.
Heidi.
It was really, really great. It is a real show. And not just like a little act. Like we could watch a whole show with you. Well done, young man.
Look, I've seen a lot of magic on these shows over the years. And I think you really, really have something special about you. You're 14 years yeah. old and you've come all the way, thousands of miles, to come up with something so incredible. Just blew my mind. I really love you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Today, I will show you guys a card trick. I practiced this for a long time. First effect is finding four aces. Watch carefully. Ooh, the first ace is here. Do you see this arrow card? This arrow card will help me whenever I make a mistake. Okay, next, second, and third, the last. Ooh, Ace of Spades. From now, I will put this arrow card in my pocket right here. Everyone can see it. Anyway, I got four aces. And Simon, please shuffle the card.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna. Oh. Can I take anyone?
Oh, no, 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 no. Just only for shuffle. Yeah. Thank you so much. And now, Amanda.
Yes.
Please touch any card. This card. Show it to everyone. And I brought something. This is a wallet. Empty wallet. Empty wallet. I'm broke. Watch. I got Ace of Diamond, Club, Heart. Oh, you picked the Ace of Spades, right?
Yeah.
Can I get this? You picked the Ace of Spades. I will find the all spades from the deck. Watch. Ace. Two. Three, four, and five is here. Six, and seven, eight. That is all I can do. So I use this arrow card to find the nine of spades. And next, oh. Thank you. The other aces in my wallet. And put it away. And again, I will put this arrow card in my pocket right here. No switch, no switch. Almost. Three more to go. One, two, three. And I hope this is Jack, Queen, King. Uh-oh. I think this card is Jack of Spades.
ace? Another ace? Of course.
Look. Jack of spades. Queen of spades. Lost.
What?
Oh, yes. There we go. I found the king of spades.
Oh, my God.
Ha-ha.
What? What?
Thank you very much. And this is... Kimo.
I hate this bitch.
Judges, the time's to play.
I don't want to play with you.
I have a tale to tell, a little look into the future. You, let us look into the future together.
Okay.
Face forwards.
Okay.
Close your eyes. Listen for a word in your mind.
Okay.
Tell no one, not when you have the word. Took you long enough. In the deepest, darkest forests of the world, wanders a creature of magnificence. The female of the species, in all of her youth and innocence. She is compelled to search the forest and gift what she finds to others. Let us help her gift these things. You, little man. Choose a color that represents a number.
Red.
Red. 3.
Great.
You choose a color.
A purple, please.
One. Alicia.
You said my name.
Choose a color.
Yellow, please.
4. Hello, Amanda.
Hello.
You don't like me very much, do you?
No.
Hello. Isn't she marvelous? Yeah.
That's a big box.
Shut up! Read on, Alicia. Continue the tale.
My heart. Okay. It was a dark and strange night in the forest. There was a stench of mold and decay in the air from David's fallen, rotten fruit.
Yes.
Oh.
Fallen, rotten fruit.
Alicia's fear began to build. Her fear wound up tight like a jack in the box.
Continue.
In front of Amanda.
Oh, grow up. Continue.
In front of Amanda, a childhood memory of times gone by, a cuddly teddy bear.
Continue.
As the little girl...
Louder!
Mud, she couldn't help but dream of a beautiful white Christmas. Just then, for Penn, the snow began to fall.
God. What was the word that was in your mind?
Chaos.
Chaos?
Oh!
Alicia, finish the tale.
The winds began to blow. The air became bitter. The little girl became lost in an overwhelming fear in a storm of pure chaos.
Chaos! Chaos! You wanted chaos? We'll give you chaos.
No.
Okay. Does anyone have sunglasses right now?
I do.
All right, Grace, would you mind if I borrow?
What's she bringing sunglasses to work for?
Because she's a star.
Oh, okay.
Cool, thank right? you.
That's it, you never see him again.
Hit it for him.
You found a whole new way of presenting magic, and you've just got a real star quality.
Thank you.
It was super cool. You look amazing. Your sleight of hand and everything is just impeccable.
Thank
so
you.
Well done.
Thank you so much.
Simon, what did you think?
I think you are brilliant.
Thank
and
you.
Your stage presence is sensational. One of the best magicians we've seen all year.
Wow.
Really?
Thank you.
slick, choreographed to perfection. Definitely want to see more from you.
Thank
you. Brilliant audition. So I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
I'm saying yes.
I'm saying yes.
I'm actually going to say yes.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Well,
breathe.
She seems a little nervous.
Okay. Right. Sorry. I'm back, and I've actually been learning how to use my magic to try and get free things. Okay. You know, since I didn't win the $1 million. Mel, you know all about how to get drinks for free, huh?
Whoa.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, excuse me, sorry. You need a drink as well.
Yeah.
I got you. Think of your favorite.
Whoa.
Cheers.
Is this?
Is it?
This is my favorite tequila.
Oh my God. I have an espresso because I keep the energy.
Terry?
Yes?
Can I see your credit card, please?
My card? I feel like I'm at home.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Terry's credit card, we're gonna put it in the wallet, and I want you to put your hand on top to keep it safe. Yes.
Okay.
Now, Mel, I'm going to show you what got me here.
Go on.
Go ahead and say stop.
Stop.
Lock the card in your brain, and I'm gonna show everybody at home. Got it? Take the cards, I don't want to touch them.
Yeah.
This card represents you very well, actually.
Yeah, it does.
It does? You're a Gemini?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're born in May?
Yeah.
The fifth month, so it's a 5?
Yeah.
And you like diamonds? Because
yeah.
Who doesn't? So it's the 5 of diamonds?
Yes!
Oh, that's good.
Go ahead and take the card out of the middle, take the 5 of diamonds.
Where is it?
Take a look.
It's not here.
You spread them out on the table, are you sure?
It's not there.
It's gone?
It's not there.
Well, the only cards I care about are playing cards, and I always carry one with me at all times in my wallet.
No, it's
Terry.
Not.
I have my hand here the whole time.
Raise your hand up off the wallet.
Right. No way.
Shut up. I'm diamond.
That is amazing. That is amazing. That's my card.
If Mel B's 5 of diamonds is in the wallet, then Terry, your card is missing.
Yeah,
where is your card?
Oh, I'm gonna need that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What is the first thing they tell you to do when you lose your credit card?
Call them.
Yes, you call the bank and you tell them to freeze the card, right? So I've already gone ahead and frozen your card for you. No,
okay.
Literally. Literally, your card is frozen in ice in front of you all this entire
Stop
time.
Stop it! No! 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 It's there!
Oh.
It's there!
What?
Are you joking?
Wait, there's only one way to find out, and I brought my special magic wand with me. Terry, can you really confirm that that is your credit card?
I'm going to confirm this right now. Yes! That is my credit card! Got my name on it.
America, cheers! Drinks are on Terry. Thank you all so much for having me back.
Thank you, Anna. That was incredible, incredible.
Mel, you were right there. What do you think?
Oh my God, you are brilliant. And the tequila's got me a little bit, but you are great.
I did that on purpose, because the more you drink, the better the magic will get.
Simon, what did you think?
Well, look, she's that good that she nearly won the entire series.
Yes.
Yes. And you did it in your own unique, cool way. We have some incredible magic tonight, but I really genuinely hope that the audience get behind you and put you through to the next round, because you deserve it.
Thank you.
A pack of playing cards is one of the most important things to a street magician. I carry this deck with me everywhere I go, and it still amazes me all the miracles that can be achieved with just a simple pack of playing cards.
Oi!
Hey! Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. I understand. The traffic starts jumping with folks like me. On a job from 9 to 5.
Check this.
Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living. 9 to 5.
To a lot of people. It's mystery, it's uncertainty, it's risk. And when I create a magic trick, I want to challenge myself. I have a genuine fear of small spaces, so I wanted to create a routine that would challenge that fear using magic to overcome it. I'm going to get Stephen to jump up on stage. Give him a massive round of applause.
The magical bones. What do you want to do, my man?
So, can we just have a little tap around the crate? Just make sure it is a solid wooden crate.
Yep.
Let's spin it around.
So spin people, it.
Yeah, we'll get the boys to spin it around so that you can see it at the back. Okay.
Yep.
And I'm going to get the boys to open up so you can see what's inside.
Okay.
Make sure there's no hidden elephants, rabbits, or no trapdoors.
Yep. Magical bones, this is for real.
Fantastic. Stephen, if you just come around here for me,
yep.
Mel is going to tie me in these vintage style handcuffs. Make sure it's nice and tight. You have a little tug there.
Make that solid.
This is my least favorite bit. This is a good old neck brace.
Mel's having the time of her life.
Yeah. Very nice of you to lend him all this stuff, Stephen.
Have a little tug there, Stephen. Make sure this is what it is.
Mate, this is for real. Look, okay. They're solid.
Your work is done. Give him a massive round of applause.
No worries.
Sometimes the world can seem like a scary place, but if you free your mind, the rest will follow.
Ago, my journey in magic began by accident. One night, a friend of mine, Dean,
had a pack of cards in his hand, and I asked Dean to take a card out without looking at it, to place it face down on the table. I asked Dean to name a card, and he said the Four of Hearts. When I turned over that card, it was the Four of Hearts. And in that moment, my destiny changed. That's when I realized how powerful magic is. This here is the actual card from all those years ago. And every time I see it, it reminds me to be grateful, because I know if it wasn't for my army friends, I wouldn't be here tonight. Amanda, can you please touch the back of any one of these cards and hold your finger on one of the cards for us, whichever one feels lucky to you. This one here. Thank you, Amanda. Now, these cards tonight are made up of 51 unprinted cards and just one lucky Four of Hearts.
Oh my God.
Amanda, can you please write your name on the card? Nice and clearly for us. We're gonna lose your card into the pack tonight, Amanda. Do you mind, Amanda, can I borrow one of your rings? Is that okay?
Yes.
If I borrow that? Thank you very much. Amanda, I would like you to think of some of the people in your life right now who have helped you in some way. In some way that they've helped make a difference to you. We have people who change us in some way. Just like Dean and my army friends did for me, they changed my journey all those years ago. It's often in our darkest moments, when we feel lost, that our true friends help us light up the direction for us to follow. Amanda, your ring has burnt through all of these cards, all the way until one card. This is your lucky card. But Amanda, this is more than just a card now. Please hold on to it tightly and please bring it with you onto stage now.
Okay.
Amanda, do you mind if I take the card back for a second? Your name, Amanda, on this card. Please hold your right hand flat. Now, Amanda, I would like you to think of just one person in your life. One person who went above and beyond when you needed it most. Do you have a name in your mind? Who is this person?
Her name is Pippa Nightingale. She delivered my baby and she saved my life.
Amanda, you're going to keep this card just like I kept Dean's card all those years. Every time you see it, you'll be reminded of all the people you're grateful for in life, but more importantly, you'll be reminded of your friend Pippa Nightingale.
No way! There's no way you would know that!
Please hold your hand flat and hold my hand, because I have one more gift for you.
Everybody, Richard Jones! Wow, wow, wow.
Knocking everywhere.
Emotional. Alicia.
Richard, you are by far one of the finest winners we've ever had on Britain's Got Talent. When I see you, I'm reminded how proud I am to work on this show. You are fantastic, my friend. The storytelling, the heart, how much this means to you, and I'm proud of you once again.
But you're always trying to make magic personal, to have a story, and have something that touches our hearts, and you certainly did that absolutely beautifully.
What did you think of this tonight?
Well, I love you, Richard. You just get better and better and better. You just draw us in, and then you do something utterly extraordinary. And it was the perfect mixture of one being an incredible trick and one being incredibly emotional as well. Wow. I mean, I take my hat off to you. It was extraordinary.
First of all, I can't believe you got picked. I don't know how you did that. She's an extraordinary person, and you're an extraordinary magician, because it's the emotional pull, it's the story, it's everything that goes with you that makes magic believable and real, and it was amazing.
How do you feel when you hear those comments?
6 years ago, so many people went out of their way to help me. And every time I come back, I feel that love straight away. Thank you so much.
Welcome to our Las Vegas party suite. If I look around, it looks like we had a crazy night last night.
Yeah, because we celebrated a very special day, May 31st, 2016.
The date of our very first audition on America's Got Talent. And thinking about it, it just feels like it was yesterday.
Speaking of yesterday, I have no memory of what happened at last night's party. Do you, judges?
No.
Okay. Amelie will try to reach into your minds to find out what we did last night.
I have to put on this blindfold because that helps me get focused.
Simon, there are a bunch of different VIP cards and lanyards from Vegas attractions. We want to keep things random, so just take one of the strings, anyone you like.
Okay.
Yes, take it. Don't say what it is, just look what you've selected.
Oh, God.
Cover it with your hands. Concentrate on it and send your thoughts to Amelie.
Yes, I remember now, Simon. You insisted on going to this very special show, and that one was called Vegas Dark Divas.
Vegas Dark Divas.
It is Vegas Dark Divas.
Wow. Great show.
And Mel B, I kind of have the feeling we had something to eat last night. At least, that would explain all these menus on the table, like here, burgers, Thai, steakhouse.
Yeah.
Just make it random. Just point to any menu, anyone, whatever you like.
Check it out.
Yeah. Select one of the food options on there. Howie, come a little bit closer.
Okay.
Show Howie and myself, just with your finger, what you have selected. This?
Okay.
Don't say it. Amelie?
Okay, Melby, I think you went kind of for a breakfast. I guess something like fruits. You went for the raspberry yogurt parfait.
Yes, raspberry yogurt parfait.
It is.
I saw that.
Yeah.
Howie,
what?
You see all these room keys on the table.
Okay.
Confirm, all room numbers are different, right?
It seems that way, yes.
2129, let's okay. Take some, put them inside here. I will look away, reach inside, and just take one room key. Not
okay.
Two. You
I've
have
got
one.
I've got one.
Hold it against your body.
Howie.
What?
A pretty clear picture comes into my mind. Because yesterday night, we were walking around the casino, and you were wearing a bathrobe.
I was?
Oh, there's Howie's bathrobe. And Heidi, can you do me a favor? Can you read out loud what it says inside?
Do not remove from room 120.
Howie, for the first time, what room have you picked?
No.
120.
It is room 120! Here, you get your rope back. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
But wait a second. All the random selections you made are associated to numbers. Mel B, let us know what is the name of the restaurant you picked.
Cafe 53.
Howie's room is 120. And Simon, can I have a look?
You may.
You're sitting in row 1, seat 6. Because Heidi, I remember you did heavy gambling last night and you won. Can you remember?
No.
You
no.
Can't, but oh. Heidi, I do have the proof because you won $53,120 in no. 16 cents.
Like Mel B's cafe, Howie's room, and Simon's row and seat.
Oh, those are all the numbers.
I'm so sorry, Heidi. We already spent all that money
what?
On this. Everybody, stand up. Try and catch a bill.
Because on the bills, you will see the faces of the judges. Mel B's holding her menu from Cafe 53.
Howie has his room number 120.
Oh, and Simon holding his show ticket, row 1, seat 6.
How is that possible?
That's insane.
There is a reason this all happened.
It all started on one day, May 31st, 2016. You remember the day of our audition?
Yes.
Everyone, have a close look or on this check.
May 31st, 2016. Thank you so much.
Thank you, America. Thank you, judges.
Thank you.
How do you think he got here today?
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Keiji Iwasaki.
Where are you from?
I'm from Japan.
Oh, I love Japan.
Ah, thank you so much.
Watashi wa arigatou.
Oh, yes, exactly.
Yes.
Oh, this is...
That's all I know. how old are you?
Yeah, I'm 49 years old.
And what you're doing for us today, is that your day job?
No, it's my bicycle and... No. Sorry. Pardon. I'm a little bit nervous, so excuse me.
No worries, my darling. So why Britain's Got Talent?
It's because a big stage, the biggest stage in the world, then it's like one of my dreams to come here.
Oh, fantastic.
Yes, it's amazing.
Wow, it's a pleasure to have you.
Yeah.
And what would you do with the money if you were to win?
I want to across the Atlantic Ocean by rowing boat. So
yes.
Then I want to buy the boat.
Oh, fabulous.
You didn't expect that answer, did you?
No one's ever said that.
I love that. Yeah.
Okay, well,
yeah.
Whenever you're ready.
Yes.
Go for it.
Okay, now I start.
Yeah. Oh, my God, I love him.
I'm laughing already.
Simon, hello.
Hello.
How are you? Because 100 times I saw you in YouTube. Hey, Simon, do you know this one?
Chopstick.
Yes, chopstick. One, two, three. Sorry. One more time. Just this.
What did you just do?
It's not magic, I'm joking. Let's start the magic.
He's good. He's funny.
Well, then maybe ask the Deacon the aunt.
Yes!
Deck it, Andrew. That's got a ring to it. It's Anton Deck.
Please check this card is normal.
Normal.
Normal. And please shuffle it.
Of course.
Yes.
Very well. Deck shuffle there.
Deck
shuffled.
Yes.
By Deckanant.
Yes. Please take one card as you like.
Me?
Yeah. No.
No.
Next.
Still me.
No. Okay, please show everybody. I don't see it. I don't want to see it. Okay, please show the audience.
No, I'm doing this bit.
Okay, may I put it here? And I just scroll. Now I show the Japanese way to shuffling. Okay.
Water.
Here, your card is water. There. The queen, this or this?
No,
that's not. This one?
No.
This? No. What? Just here. Is your card?
Yes.
Wow. How do you put the card in and then empty it?
No, I put... Just move. Hop. Whoa. Did you see it? It's my hand. No.
That's so good.
Stop. Dance the island. Hop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Amazing.
I didn't know Japan was creating wizards. What's going on over here?
£20. And do you want it?
No.
I put here £20. Hop. What? It's like a going to energy of this nature. Excuse me, energy finished. But no problem. Genki dama! My last trick is for ladies.
For ladies?
Yes. Alicia, do you come over here?
I come over here.
Well,
you didn't do an awful lot there, did you?
He didn't ask us to, did he?
Alicia! Okay, arigato. Please check this is what?
What is this?
It's a ring.
It's a ring, yes. Give me a finger like this. I put the ring here, okay? Just hold on, don't move, because it's a very difficult magic. This ring, your finger. Hat, one, two, three. Passing. Whoa! Alicia, wait! Wait! Hold on! Hop! What?
You are very, very charming, and your magic was absolutely excellent.
Yes.
I mean, faultless.
So much. It's too much.
You're the funniest person we've seen and the most magical person we've seen, all combined in one, and I love you.
Yes, thank you so much.
You are an absolute natural. People are going to like you so much. My son is going to love you. I mean, love you. You are one of the best we've seen so far.
Isn't that lovely?
Yes, thank you so much.
The audience love you. I love you too. You're a superstar, so I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
Yes, thank you so much.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Thank you so much. I can't explain my emotion. I never expected Gordon Brothers. It's too much. Thank you so much.
Hi.
I have a deck of cards to help me tell a story. Alicia, can you help me out? Can you give them a little shuffle? Give them a little mix up. Beautiful. Ooh, this
don't
is...
judge me. They're a new pack of cards.
Oh, wow. You're upstaging me now. I don't like it.
There you go. That will do. That will do, Magic
Perfect.
Mike.
You have shuffled the hell out of it. Shane, can you help me?
Yeah, of course.
I'm going to get you to say stop whenever you like.
Stop.
Have a look. Don't let me see it, actually. Can you sign it on the face of the card? And nice and big, right, Shane? You can show the other judges. You can hold it up and show the team if you trust them.
There it is there.
Perfect. Thank you. Throw it in the middle here.
Copy that.
Lovely. Done. Thank you. David, I'm actually got the biggest man crush on you, so I want to start here. Is that all right?
The feeling's mutual.
Oh,
and if you do want to take off your clothes, Magic Mike, feel free.
Everyone has their price, David. We can sort this out. But I honestly, I've came here to tell you all a story.
Okay.
That means a lot to me, and I hope you like it. It's actually a story about a guy I know named Jack. And if you met Jack, you'd probably think he's the luckiest guy in the world. I mean, he's got a loving family and plenty of mates. And they think he's kind of funny. They always think of him as a bit of a joker. And when he's out in the town with his mates, they really get around him. They call him the king, which is kind of ironic because whenever the night ends up at the karaoke bar, he's the one always singing Queen.
Wow.
But even on the most joyous of occasions, like Christmas or even his birthday, he'd often look around at the full house of family and friends having such a good time. And he'd stop and think, what's wrong with me? Like, why can't I have fun? And the more he thought about this, the worse he felt. And the worse he felt, the more guilty he felt. And all of a sudden, he'd have shame and become flush with emotion. So what would Jack do? He'd find a nice, quiet room in the house and cry. You see, Jack was a 28-year-old man. And in his mind, 28-year-old males, they needed to be strong. They didn't talk about their feelings. And it wasn't until he learned that 1 in 10 Australians actually seek professional help that he realized he wasn't alone. And that's what gave him the courage to talk to his friends. And when he did, they thought it showed true heart to talk about his feelings. So he started to do some research and he was shocked to learn that in the most recent year, 3,318 Australians took their own lives. That's 63 people every single week. 63. And for every person that did, another 20 attempted to. In Australia, suicide is the leading cause of death for people aged between 15 to 44. And he didn't want to become another statistic. But do you know what really helped, Jack? It was hearing other people's stories. And not just stories from his friends and family, but stories from Australian royalty. Australians in politics, Australians in fashion and business, even some Australian sporting legends. Hearing these people share their own personal stories about their struggles helped Jack recognize his fears and made him realize he's not alone. So do you know what Jack decided to do? Jack decided to share his story on Australia's Got Talent. And by sharing this story today, I hope I can make just at least one person get their head straight. So now more than ever, do we need people to have the courage to reach out. There's a trained professional, just a phone call away, 24/7.
Don't cry, mate.
I want all Australians, genuinely, who are struggling with their mental health, to remember that without the rain, there can be no rainbow. So I want all Australians to shine bright like a diamond. Thank you.
God.
A man named John Hill has murdered 5 men. His last victim was found holding this book. Amanda, hold the bell in your hand. Ring the bell. Stop. Ring it again. Stop. I sense you have special powers.
Didn't do anything then.
Amanda, what was the name of his last male victim?
Tom?
Let us see if you are right. There is 800 pages in this book. Tell me any page number.
57.
Now, open book at 57. Tear out the page from the book. Amanda, bring me the paper.
I'm sorry, babe. May the Lord be with you.
God. the name again.
Tom.
Open the book on the missing page.
It says, Tom.
That's the victim's name. Let's find Tom.
Oh no, let's not. Let's not find Tom.
John Hale's victims. Which one do you think is Tom? Look at the photo. Amanda,
yeah.
What you don't realize is that Tom has been with you
no
longer than what you think. Simon, pick up the photo and look at it.
No. My God.
This is not the end. It's just the beginning.
I'm just going to grab something from over here. Oh. Amanda, please hold the balloon by the stick. Balloons are the first thing that we all learn to lose. Like the child that lost this balloon earlier today. They thought it was a gust of wind. It wasn't. It was me. I stole it to teach a lesson. Loss. You might think it was rather mean to burst a balloon like that, but losing things is an important part of life. I'll show you what I mean. Amanda, the box on this trolley is the theater's lost property box. Please open the lid. Without showing anyone, Amanda, you will take one of the items and place it under the cloth on the trolley. Being invisible means I can't have material possessions of my own. So, instead, I just steal them from other people. And better yet, I can compel other people to do my bidding. Alicia, reach in with your right hand. Take a random object and hold it so no one can see what you chose. holding a secret in your hands. One that nobody could possibly know. Remember, you could have taken anything from that box, and yet Amanda knows exactly what you have taken.
Joy.
Amanda, I want you to take a deep breath and tell everyone what Alicia is holding in her right hand.
A dummy. No way.
This is weird.
But there's just one object left to identify. The one that you took at the beginning, Amanda. There is a piece of chalk on the trolley. Please pick it up and bring it to me over here. I'm standing in front of the blackboard. And let go of it, Amanda. I will take it from here.
How is it doing that?
Amanda, please lift the cloth. Show everyone what you put there. Please keep hold of those keys and take them back to your seat. You see, I've been amongst you these last few days. It's just that no one ever saw me.
This is unreal. I feel like I'm in a television. It's just...
You are.
You are. It's a big deal, right?
Oh, yeah. It's a big deal. The biggest deal in my life.
What's your name, my friend?
My name is Atsushi Ono.
Atsushi, where are you from?
This time I flew from Japan, but I was living in Calgary for 15 years.
What do you do?
I'm a magician. So.
Magician?
Yes.
So how are you feeling? Are you nervous?
I'm both nervous and nervous. Very nervous.
But
I'm shaking.
Should I stop asking you questions now?
No. I'm
yeah.
Yeah. No.
Here we go. The stage is yours.
Wow. Thank you so much. So all I need is nothing but your imagination. So Howie, I wanted to guess what this is. I'm going to place it right here. Can you guess?
Yes. That is nothing.
Nothing. Very close. But it's actually a wine cork. It's difficult to tell because you didn't visualize it. But if I do this... I hope you can imagine that I'm a coin. And can you visualize it now?
Oh.
You can also hear it.
Right.
One coin. And I want to imagine I have another one on my fingertips. Just a simple matter of visualizing. I got two, and I like number three, so why not? It's just one, two, three coins. I like three. You know what? I have an idea. I have a lighter here.
Fire.
And three becomes two.
Oh my God.
What?
And two become one. I have no idea why it works, but it works. Just like that. Watch.
It's gone.
Right here. He's gone. I did that.
Magic.
I did that. You see? I made him disappear.
You made Cardi disappear.
Yeah.
Wow.
Imagine, it's getting softer and softer. Softer and softer. Now I can stretch. As if your imagination is growing. And what I wanted to show is whether you believe the last few minutes were real or just a figment of your imagination. I want to thank you for letting me share my reality. Thank you so much.
Oh my God, look, look! There's a cork! There's a cork! There's a cork!
Wow. Wow. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh. Wow. Well,
I have no idea how that happened.
You're so nervous. You think, especially when you're doing sleight of hand, you would think that, and I could see you really close. Your palms are, you're really sweaty too.
Yes. Yes. And then sticky too.
You're sticky.
Very sticky and it's stinky. Yes.
You're so funny. I love it.
Anytime there's a good magician, if you see me going away, that means you're doing well because otherwise.
Yes. That's what I loved. I love that, like, when he disappeared, you brought it into your act,
That's right.
I thought that was a real winning moment for me.
Well, I would love to start off the voting with your first yes.
Wow. Thank you.
I would like to make your second yes appear.
Yes. Wow. I would like to make any doubt disappear with another yes.
That's three yeses.
And as you have made me reappear, you have four yeses!
What's your name, sir?
My name is Jamie Skelton.
Skeleton?
Skelton, please.
So Skelton is your real name?
Yes, it's not a magician name.
So are you a magician?
I am indeed, yes.
Well, that works out.
I know, well done. Okay, so do you want to start? Do you want us to intro you? Do you come out of ceiling or fly or come down? Or do you just start?
Yeah, well, if it's okay with you guys and everyone else here, I'd just like to come join you at your
table. Come on down, Jamie, come down.
Hey, guys, how are we? So, Louis, I'm going to start with yourself. Louis, I want to show you a card trick that doesn't actually use any cards. Just this. I want you to check this out as closely as you can. Watch.
Oh! Hey! Yeah.
That's a souvenir for you.
That's cool.
Thank you, Jamie. Michelle.
Yes.
What I'd like you to do, it's quite simple. I'd like you to pick out a card for me, okay? And it doesn't matter if I see this card or seen this trick before, okay? So what I'd like you to do is just take out any card you'd like and just slide it towards yourself. That's perfect, so we can all see it. Queen of Spades, perfect. So what I want you to do is I want you to write your name as big as you can across the card there. You can write your credit card details
like this
as well.
Way? No,
across the white
far.
Part there. That's perfect. So this way we know there's no cheating, I'm not using any duplicates or anything like that. That is the only card like that in the world with Michelle's name. Is that fair enough?
Yeah.
Perfect, okay, that's great. Now, Michelle, that's the only card like that in the world. I'm gonna get you to push it into the middle for me. So just push it all the way in there. That's brilliant. Now, Jason, I know you're a bit of a trickster, you probably don't trust me. So I'm gonna try this on yourself. I'm going to give the cards a good mix. If you wouldn't mind just holding out your hand flat for me for a moment, okay?
Yeah.
That's perfect. Now, we all know that that's obviously not Michelle's card. It's the Queen of Diamonds. But if I was to take the Queen of Diamonds, if I was to just wave it over your hand, the heat from your hand actually changes the ink, melts it, and makes it look like that Queen of Spades with Michelle's name on it. Which is quite strange. Not too bad. Now, Denise, earlier on, I actually made a prediction. Now, it's fair to say, none of us, especially you, Michelle, we haven't sent anything up beforehand. I haven't asked you to write your name on loads of Queen of Spades or anything like that. Inside my pocket here, I've had a prediction the entire time. Now, inside my wallet, there's actually a zipper compartment. This has been closed the entire time. Inside the zipper compartment, there's actually a card. Denise, if you could verify this for me, it's the Queen of Spades. What I don't understand is how Michelle got her name on that card there. Which is quite strange. Just check that out.
I don't know that one.
I have no idea how that works either. Yeah, Jason, well, yeah. I'd like to finish with you if you just hold out both your hands flat again for me.
Don't hit me in the face.
I won't, don't worry. that's Michelle's job.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'll do it.
Oh, no, she will.
Yo, don't worry. That's perfect. If you could put your other hand on top of the deck for me and just cover it just like that, that's brilliant.
Okay.
Now, at the start of this, I said to you guys that I was going to show you a trick with no cards. No cards, no ink, nothing.
Uh-oh.
Watch this. Squeeze as tight as you can.
Squeeze what?
Your hands together.
Oh. Cards.
Watch this. One. Two. Very slowly.
Yeah.
Lift up your hand, Jason.
Okay.
And you'll see that the deck has actually changed into a solid block of cards.
That is brilliant. Brilliant.
That's awesome.
Well done.
Don't touch me.
Hop back up there, really Jamie. Cool. Jamie, that was really cool.
Oh, I hope so.
That's what I would call a kind of freaky magic.
It is. It's a bit weird, yeah.
Yeah, because like a lot of the card trees can be quite flat and boring, and like and the signing one, you know, you could have seen that, and then in the wallet, yeah, that's good. But that last bit, that was a good finale.
Brilliant.
That
Thank
was
you
really
much.
Good. Louis, what do you think of that card trick?
Really good, Jamie. I think you're a cut above the rest.
Yeah.
I love your act. I think it's great. I mean, I was completely blown away by it. And obviously, we're sat really close and can see everything, and I don't know how you did that. It was brilliant. And you're also really good at holding an audience and keeping our interest as well. I absolutely loved it. It was fantastic.
Well, they're a great audience, and so are you guys. So thanks for having me.
That was so amazing. We were right there, right up in it. I was looking between his hands. I still don't know how you did it. And you have great eyebrows. So there's that.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Jamie, we're going to vote. You need three yeses to get through. So, Louis?
Jamie Skelton, I am going to say absolutely yes.
Yes, well done. One yes. Denise?
I'd like to see what else you've got in your box of tricks. Is a yes from me.
Two yeses. We just need one more, Michelle.
You're going to get a yes from me. I can't wait to see what else you
got. Well done, Jamie. Yes from me as well. It was brilliant. Well done, Jamie Skelton.
Thank you,
Jamie.
Yeah.
Thanks, Jamie.
That was awesome. I watched in between his hands.
That was very...
Literally saw though. Nothing.
8:46 p.m. That was the exact moment that Ant and Dec gave me the golden buzzer at the London Palladium back in 2018. A moment that has simply changed my life. Can we please welcome our host for this evening, Mr. Stephen Mulhern, to the stage. Good to see you, Stephen.
Good to see you.
So I'd like to share something with you.
Yep.
So we have a pack of playing cards, and all I'm gonna do is go through the cards one at a time.
Right.
Wherever you say stop, that will be the card.
Okay. Stop.
Ten of hearts.
Yeah.
Stephen, can you hold out your hand for me, palm up? I'll place that 10 on your hand, hold still for me. There are 51 other possibilities from a red deck of playing cards. Stephen, you have just done something really quite amazing and you don't even know it yourself. Because you, not I, have actually found Magician X. Wow. A round of applause for you, Stephen. Thank you very much indeed. And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage my alias, the incredible Magician X.
X! It is a pleasure to see you again.
Pleasure.
So on the screen now is a list of words. Judges. Would all four of you please think of a word on the screen?
Screen, think.
Pen, in front of you, you'll see there is a clipboard and a pen. Can I ask you to think of a word that resonates with you on the screen and write it down in the first position? Once you've done that, Pen, you'll pass it along to Amanda, and then you'll pass it along to Alicia, and lastly, David, you'll write your word down at the end. Now, of all the amazing times that we have had on Britain's Got Talent, and there have been many, neither of us could have predicted how people all around the world would identify and connect with Magician X.
Yeah, Magician X.
You see, I believe that magic is real. Pen, inside the box that X has is a remote control. Can you please press play on the remote control?
The best way to predict the future is to create it.
Pen, what was your word?
Word.
Peace!
Amanda, what was your word?
Humility.
Anisha, which word did you choose?
Compassion.
And finally, David, what was your word?
Bliss.
My daddy said we should always remember nothing is
impossible.